somewhat attracting people to the area. But in more recent years, design is also a big focus. Can I get a show of hands for anyone who's worked at a company with a team called the creative department or the creative team? Yeah, so usually they're like the marketing, branding, visual design, industrial design group. Maybe they wear cool glasses that's all in black. I know that's not a real person, but I also know a few creatives are a bit like that. Even at Google, they use this language around creatives. Here's a job opening for a creative lead on the Google Cloud team. Can I get a second show of hands if you are not someone who would be typically hired to this team? If you're not in interaction, is that? Yeah, exactly. Is this because we are non-creatives? Of course not. We create a lot of things, algorithms, product strategies, processes. We are all creatives. At the same time, I continue to meet colleagues who look at how I work and say, I wish I was creative like that. And by creative, it seems like they reach me, I wish I knew how to draw. Well, you know what? You can draw. And today, you are going to do the scariest form of drawing, portrait drawing. Now, before we panic, the craft of drawing is no more mysterious than any other discipline. It takes some time, it takes some practice, it takes an art degree, and hitting. In fact, we're not going to call it an art, it is a creative practice. So I put all around the room materials for you. There are, for those who don't already wear glasses, a pair of child-sized novelty sunglasses. These are optional to wear, but I'm going to put mine on because glasses of any shape are not embarrassed if you draw them poorly. There is also a Sharpie and a piece of cardstock. Please uncap your markers. Johannes, I'm going to borrow you. You will partner with me for this. And face your partner. We're going to start pairing up roughly from here. Pairs, pairs.
We go from there.
Maybe say hello to your partner.
Hi. Hello.
Before we begin, two very special instructions. Number one, do not look down at your paper while you draw.
No.
Number two, do not lift your marker from your paper.
Oh.
What you're going to do is basically trace what you see in front of you in one continuous line.
What?
And this is going to be a really, really quick exercise, just 1 minute long. Keep your marker moving as soon as I start the timer.
Really? Really?
So, reminder, don't look down. Don't lift your marker. Trace what you see.
Yeah. This is hard.
You can do it.
You can't look down. Are you ready?
Yes.
Is that a timer of 1 minute?
We can't look down.
So you did.
Yep. 1 minute from now.
And so you might need to take a picture. I will recommend starting with the sunglasses in the middle. You can draw one star. Then you can draw the other star.
Can you see? I look down a little bit.
Okay. 15 seconds left.
Draw what? Draw you.
Ah, I gotta keep the time.
Draw me. Oh my god, I draw wrong thing. Draw partner. Draw partner. I didn't draw you.
Time's up.
Because you can't look down at the paper, your eyes learn to truly
very handsome.
That's you.
What is in front of them, not what you think or assume is in front of them.
Pretty
in fact,
cool.
To show you just how far practice can take you, before the advent of photography, drawing was a requirement for biology students because only way you could record visual information. But a few years ago, a North Carolina State University professor brought drawing back to her biology classes because drawing taught her students the unbiased observational skills that just didn't come from reading or writing about biology. And what you see here are not drawings from experienced artists. They're from biology students after just one drawing course. So pretty inspiring. That said, you might be wondering, why drawing? Why arts? Why, at this point in my career? One reason is that there are benefits for design collaborations. We know that sometimes design can make or break the products we create. Sometimes it's the difference between breaking open an industry and fading from it. So for my colleagues, one of the other big requests is they wish they knew how to make design decisions or how to recognize when they're good or not. So having an arts practice will naturally give you, well, practice, the skills that go into design decisions, observing, making, editing, critiquing. And I came across some fantastic articles from engineers and product managers who dabbled a bit in arts and design. And they found that with a shared vocabulary, they were much better at giving feedback. But in addition to this, they found that having another discipline made them better at seeing other perspectives. A computer scientist mentioned that he started to see tasks not as, can I build that, but who am I building that for? And this made him a more open, better computer scientist. This leads me to the second reason, which is having an arts practice strongly correlates with success outside of the arts. For example, did you know that Nobel Prize winners are almost 3 times more likely to have an artistic or crafty hobby compared to regular scientists? The researchers who found these findings, they speculate that perhaps non-linear exploratory nature of artistic practices foster creative discovery and creative connection making for these high achieving scientists. I can personally demonstrate that exploration and mistakes are part of the process, even after years of experience. The one drawing I've been using as my final drawing is actually the product of 13 drawings. Now, the scientists' hobbies here weren't limited to visual design or visual arts. They practiced music, theater, poetry, dance, glassblowing. And I bet, many of you already have some kind of artistic pursuit that probably makes you better at your job. That said, drawing's really unique. I could, in theory, build out a storyboard for a product pitch in blown glass. But drawing doesn't require special skills. You can do it anywhere. And obviously, I have come with an idea. And that is, I want you to make yourself part of the creative department by spending time with a design partner. When you go to work tomorrow, ask a design colleague when there's a good day or a few hours for you to shadow them. If you don't work with design, I'm sure there's a marketing team somewhere that markets the product you work on. And ask them for a time for you to shadow them. During this time, observe how they work, how they problem solve, ask them to elaborate how and why they made certain decisions. You'll start to understand a bit more about their discipline and be able to bring that perspective to yours. And don't stop at design or engineering. Shadow other disciplines, project managers, writers, HR, lawyers, wherever you work, there is a diversity of creativity. In fact, to help foster this new drawing and collaboration practice, I've made these sketchbooks. I would love for you to do a blind contour drawing of each person you meet with. This book with your first and many future collaborations. Because the thing is, we all work in the creative department. It's part of our work, it's part of our lives, it's part of our impact on millions of lives. And it is possible because we all